A farming robot that uses artificial intelligence is set to change the game in the agriculture sector. This report tells us how.
Meet Claus, a robot created to make the future of farming more sustainable. The prototype is designed for two main tasks, weeding and crop monitoring. It's a combination of artificial intelligence and robotics, and its makers say it can get into the tough spots when farmers or other equipment cannot.
Nobody really wants to go through a field weeding on a really wet, windy, cold day, so why not give it to a robot?
CLAWS stands for Concentrated Light Autonomous Weeding and Scouting. The robot was designed by Earth Rover. It uses patented concentrated light technology to eliminate weeds without damaging surrounding crops or soil. James Miller is the CEO of the agriculture tech startup.
So the best way of describing it is a schoolboy with a magnifying glass. So it concentrates the light onto a small focal point on the meristem, the growing point of the weed, and delivers a small pulse of energy, which is enough to kill the weed.
On the left is what the field looks like, and on the right is what Claus sees.
It takes an individual photograph and assesses the crop beneath it, identifies the crop, protects that, and then identifies the weeds around it and says, they're enemy, I'm targeting those. And that all happens in a split second and starts shooting at the weeds.
Miller says this method is more sustainable by reducing greenhouse gas emissions that could be released during soil disturbance. To help monitor crop health, Claus is equipped with 8 built-in cameras. It collects real-time data using AI computer vision, which is then sent to Earth Rover's farm control and intelligence system. The information allows farmers to make timely decisions about the health and growth of the crop. Claus runs on battery and solar power and operates autonomously in different terrains and weather conditions. Earth Rover has plans to deliver units to customers for testing in 2025. Commercial availability is slated for 2026.
Speaking of China, local carrier Cebu Pacific reducing its operations there as it looks to expand in secondary cities in Asia. Jackie Pascual with the full story.
Cebu Pacific is reducing its flights to China as it sees more growth potential in other Asian destinations. China's outbound tourism is still recovering from the pandemic, and there are also geopolitical concerns. Cebu Pacific President Sander Lau is hopeful Chinese tourism will grow in the future, but the airline is looking at other countries for now.
Clearly, the demand to and from China, at least for us, has not been as robust compared to 2019. So some of the additional flying you are seeing today is because we've, reduced some of our China flying. We have to be pragmatic as well, considering the existing relationships between the Philippines and China. It's better suited maybe for us to redeploy our assets elsewhere and cater to demand where we see it.
Lau says there were 18 to 21 frequencies per week to mainland China before the pandemic, but by the end of this year, that will go down to just 6 to 8. The planes will instead fly to so-called secondary destinations, mostly in Southeast Asia. Cebu Pacific will fly to Chiang Mai in Thailand starting October, following a successful route to Da Nang in Vietnam last year.
A lot of the secondary ports that we fly into are actually quite, have proven to be quite popular. Bali, for example, Da Nang has done well, so we're hopeful Chiang Mai will be similar.
The budget carrier is also optimistic of growth domestically, with many airports under construction and with the expected improvements at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport because of the turnover to a private operator next month.
We are in conversations with the new NAIA Infrastructure Corporation, or NNIC, and we are closely, I guess, providing them a couple of things. Now, what are our growth ambitions? What do we think we intend to do in the new airport?
But he is also on a wait-and-see mode as there are talks of hikes in the terminal fee and other airport expenses.
We are a bit concerned. But having said that, any privatization, we should expect that some of the prices will increase to see how we can possibly, defer or reduce the impact of some of these charges.
According to the contract, the increase will only happen 1 year after the start of operations And within that period, the concessionaire is expected to deliver service improvements before any increase could be approved.
Cebu Pacific is also happy as the supply chain issue hounding airlines is slowly being resolved. The airline is also set to order up to 152 Airbus planes worth over ₱1 trillion, the largest haul in the country's aviation history. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.